Now, the other big story of the week, and that's the Charlie Hebdo. I'm not going to give you the full rundown on Charlie Hebdo and this French terrorism. We just had, on the same day, au jour le jour, I did a rundown on that, which you can find at tarpley.net. This is a lengthy radio interview. You can hear it where I go through it. Let's just add what we have. It is continuing in the sense the turmoil and the agitation in France, Germany, Netherlands, and Belgium, in particular the town of Verviers, V-E-R-V-I-E-R-S, Verviers. It's amazing to hear how few American or British, even worse, TV correspondents have any idea of the pronunciation of French. But there it is. We're told that there are 20 sleeper cells with 180 patsies ready to act, that there was a sleeper cell in Verviers with three or four patsies ready to go. Two of them are now dead, one wounded but captured. Now, we're also getting a lot of stuff about this Koulibaly network, or was it Cannibaly? Koulibaly is the one who says that he was working for ISIS, and there is some idea that the people that are getting rounded up now, these patsies, are somehow connected to Koulibaly rather more than the Guashi brothers. However, the Guashi brothers have the imprimatur of Aulaki, the CIA lackey. And anybody who says they were recruited or inspired by Aulaki, the CIA lackey, are in turn likely to be double agents working for the CIA. And there's an attempt to somehow set up a rivalry between AQAP in Yemen and the ISIS. That is an ape theater, as we'll get back to in a minute. For the Friday the 16th of January, as we're taping. Remember, very little time left to send an email to taxwallstreetparty@gmail.com and say that you want to pre-register for this upcoming seminar. I hope a great intellectual event, because others will be contributing too. That's going to be in Silver Spring, Maryland, starting on the 23rd of January, this coming Friday at 6 p.m. taxwallstreetparty@gmail.com, and world historical status can be yours. How's that for an offer? Now, as we were saying, Aulaki, the CIA lackey, is just that. He's the CIA lackey. People he recruits become CIA double agents. And, of course, he's been killed, at least so we're told, 4 years ago. But his incendiary tapes live on. So this is a kind of a crescendo. You have to ask yourself, why? Well, the why is sort of what I was saying here at the beginning. The entire financial system and world strategic situation, I think, is tending to get out of the hands of the Anglo-American zombie bankers, Wall Street, City of London, and so forth, when we have things like Belarus taxing flight capital, Russia breaking the rules and putting in informal exchange controls and capital controls. The Swiss somehow have stunned the Anglo-Americans. There's more to this, right? What the Swiss have done, the hysteria, the rage of the Anglo-Americans, it's not just a currency revaluation. The State of the Union, things will be going on there. Draghi, will it work, right? The QE that he's coming up with. The Greek vote, that's a big one, right? That's a direct political challenge. That's what they fear most, and so forth. And then this constant, what can we say, the border torture, right? Radio Shack is going to be bankrupt. The principal casinos of Atlantic City are bankrupt. Caesar's Palace in Las Vegas is bankrupt. These are strange straws in the wind. So there it is. In particular, I think the people behind these terror attacks, in other words, terrorist controllers, right, the people who steer the moles, the patsies, and the technicians, they want to put a chill on political activity, political protest. One example, out of the state of Ohio, we're getting a parade of psychotic patsies FBI patsies, people who have been quite obviously worked on, duped, manipulated by fast-talking FBI double agents, right? Entrapment agents. And the idea is that out of Ohio, we're getting this parade of patsies who are all angry at the Republicans, angry at Boehner, angry at the reactionaries who run the House of Representatives and now indeed the Senate. So we have Boehner's bartender, right? Bartender Mike, who calls Boehner's wife and says that he was the bartender and that he had had plenty of time, plenty of opportunities to administer a Mickey Finn to Boehner, and he wished he had, but now he was going to come and attack him otherwise, right? So in other words, a completely mentally impaired, psychotic individual. So that's one, and then they round him up. And then the second one is this other guy, another character. This one has converted, he says, to Islam. He's a supporter of ISIS, and he's also in his case, you can see very clearly the FBI provocateur who writes all this stuff down. It's aspirational. It's aspirational in the sense that he's nowhere near being able to do it, but he shoots his mouth off and that's enough. So now we have these two cases, right? We have bartender Mike and we have this other guy who converted to Islam, both of these Ohio patsies. What's the result of that? Suppose you want to go and have a demonstration, down with Boehner, down with the Republicans, and watch out for Congress. Aren't you chilled? Yeah, I think you're chilled. So I think that's what it is. And that's the general idea of this entire terror spree is to do that in regard to Syriza and Alexis Tsipras winning the Greek election. And the point of that is when Syriza wins, I know, of course, Goldman Sachs says that Samaras, the reactionary austerity ghoul of the IMF, they say he's going to win. Well, maybe not, probably not. We think Syriza is going to win. We want you to go out and vote for Syriza, by all means. Any person of goodwill, help them any way you can, with your vote, with your money, with publicity, anything you can do, do it. And when that happens, there's quite likely to be a labor upsurge in Europe. In other words, the long-suffering European labor movement, the unions in Europe, which are, at least on paper, still formidable organizations, they might now say, okay, enough is enough. If the Greeks can do it, we can do it too. So the idea is that what you're doing is chilling that response in advance, right? You're trying to suppress a mass strike upsurge before it happens. Now, let's also just go back. The principal reasons for the Charlie Hebdo. It is the interview given by Hollande to France Inter, the day before, 2 days before, that is to say on Monday, January 5th, Hollande had proclaimed to France Inter that he had been in contact with Putin, that he had talked to Putin about the status of Crimea and Ukraine, that Putin is not going to annex the eastern Ukrainian cities, Donetsk, Lugansk, and these areas. That is not Putin's goal, he says Hollande. The goal of Putin is simply to be important and to prevent these areas from becoming part of NATO because they're too close for comfort. And the most important single statement, Hollande says, the sanctions against Russia must end. If Russia is willing to show signs of progress, the sanctions must end. He also says he does not want to invade Libya. There's a group around General Puga, P-U-G-A, in the French General Staff. They do want to invade Libya. And the aircraft carrier Charles de Gaulle is now steaming, we hope, towards the eastern Mediterranean, not towards the Gulf of Sidra and Libya. No, not there. Go and have a go at ISIS. That's fine, but not Libya. Not at this point, anyway. And then there was this question about Greece, right, where Merkel and Samaras had been in a hysteria line, big scare. Propaganda of fear, fear campaign against Syriza. If you vote for them, it'll be chaos. It'll be the end of the world. And Hollande says, well, the Greeks should vote for who they want, and we hope they'll maintain their international obligations. The result of this is that it has succeeded. They were supposed to be at Astana in Kazakhstan on the 15th, yesterday, by the calendar. There was supposed to be a summit with Hollande, with Merkel, with Putin and with Poroshenko of Ukraine. And that has not happened, to the best of my knowledge anyway. There has been no summit of Astana. The fact that there wouldn't be one was announced by Merkel on that Sunday, right? The same day with that procession and all the stuff about that. Merkel was there and she apparently extracted from Hollande the idea that the conditions were not ripe to have that meeting. That meeting was going to be, I think, a turning point against the sanctions regime. In other words, a repudiation of Kerry and Obama and their sanctions against Russia. But the meeting has not happened. So it's a success. Now, remember, this is geopolitical terrorism. I'm afraid I have to advance my contention that I very well may be the world's leading expert in this matter, right? Going from the Morrow case of 1978 down through 9/11 synthetic terror made in USA down to the present day. Geopolitical terrorism is how NATO disciplines its alliance. Remember General de Gaulle? He bucked NATO, 30 assassination attempts. Aldo Moro was going to detach Italy from the Western Bloc, or indeed overcome the division into blocs. Kidnapped and murdered, 1978. Even this Breivik affair. The Breivik affair had to do with the bombing of Libya. Norway was going to drop out. If Norway dropped out, Holland was going to drop out. So Breivik kills the sons and daughters of the ruling party. And now Hollande. Hollande says on Monday the sanctions must end, and Wednesday Paris explodes into terrorism, and it's still going on. And whenever you see things in Belgium, Netherlands, elsewhere, the smaller NATO states are being disciplined. British, even worse, TV correspondents have any idea of the pronunciation of French, but there it is. We're told that there are 20 sleeper cells with 180 patsies ready to act, that there was a sleeper cell in Verviers with three or four patsies ready to go. Two of them are now dead, one wounded but captured. Now, we're also getting a lot of stuff about this Koulibaly network, or was it Cannibaly? Koulibaly is the one who says that he was working for ISIS. And there is some idea that the people that are getting rounded up now, these patsies, are somehow connected to Koulibaly rather more than the Guashi brothers. However, the Guashi... Now, the other big story of the week, and that's the Charlie Hebdo. I'm not going to give you the full rundown on Charlie Hebdo and this French terrorism. We just had... on the same day, au jour le jour, I did a rundown on that, which you can find at tarpley.net. This is a lengthy radio interview. You can hear it where I go through it. Let's just add what we have. It is continuing in the sense the turmoil and the agitation in France, Germany, Netherlands, and Belgium, in particular the town of Verviers, V-E-R-V-I-E-R-S. Verviers. It's amazing to hear how few American or brothers have the imprimatur of Aulaki, the CIA lackey. And anybody who says they were recruited or inspired by Aulaki, the CIA lackey, are in turn likely to be double agents working for the CIA. And there's an attempt to somehow set up a rivalry between AQAP in Yemen and